Hello, welcome back to Let's Play The Whispered World Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Playing the part of Sadwick, and he's supposed to either practice his human cannibal act or go around and look for people to join the circus. I think we're doing the latter. I think that's what he prefers.
Can I try?
The answer is no.
So you already talked to Ben. Let's see if we can talk to Grandpa now, if he'll actually say something.
Hello, Grandpa.
Oh, hello, Ben. You Grandpa. Look different. Is that a new hat you're wearing?
I'm not Ben, Grandpa.
I know, Ben. They don't make hats like they used to anymore.
I'm Sadwick.
When I was a little clown, we used to wear real hats with big, firm bubbles.
Sadwick, your grandson.
I could knock out a full-grown ox with my bubbles. I know that poor animal, but that's the way people liked their hats back then. Now, what can I do for you, Ben?
I wish you wouldn't always mistake me for Ben.
I wish you wouldn't always mistake me for Ben.
I know. The world is a vale of tears when you're young. Everybody's against you. But there are worse things than tight hats and pinching shirt sleeves, you know.
I'm paying close attention to your words of wisdom, like always.
When you're old, there are tight pains and pinching pantaloons, too. And this, my boy, is the most important lesson to take into old age. Loose-fitting pantaloons are the most loyal friends you could ever ask for.
Heavens. Did he manage to bring his pantaloons into the conversation again?
Yeah, they seem pretty legendary when we were looking at them last episode. I had one of those terrible nightmares again.
There's a cute saying I remember from my boyhood on that very subject. What was it? I forgot.
You mean the old saying, dreams are 10 a penny?
What? That's nonsense. Dreams are not 10 a penny. I once knew a guy who sold dreams at considerably higher prices. Now that I think of it, that guy might have been me.
Who in the world bought dreams?
No one. Really, that was where the plan fell short. But it was worth a try. There are always fools who spend money on any little nonsense.
How the hell would you sell dreams? Say, Grandpa, you've seen a lot of things in your life, haven't you?
Say, Grandpa, you've seen a lot of things in your time, haven't you?
You can say that again. You can ask me whatever you, whatever you can carry.
What do you know about the autumn forest?
What do you know about the autumn forest?
Ah, the autumn forest is it's an enchanted place full of mystery. Strange creatures dwell there, but not as many nowadays as in the past. In ancient times, lots of diverse tribes lived there. You can still find trace of them in ruins and in caves. When I was a child, half the valley was submerged underwater. Now, there's only that little lake with the island. That's all I can remember at the moment.
That's not surprising. You'd even forget the color of your hair if you didn't look in the mirror regularly.
But I still know that it starts with a G.
That doesn't count. You're just guessing.
But I'm right.
Why? Yes,
See? That's the word. That's all I need to know. Oh, please let it be green.
So the brother's not just nasty to Sadwick, he's nasty to Grandpa, too. I'm gonna wonder, where are their parents? Their brothers. That's their grandfather. If their parents are about anywhere. Do you know anything about nightmares and visions?
Do you know anything about nightmares and visions?
I know enough that I can't give a profound opinion about them. Only real oracles can interpret dreams. And they're the only ones that can tell you if it was a vision of some sort. I once thought I had a vision too, you know. Yes, an angel appeared and told me that one day my pantaloons would save the world. I was so excited. I went on pilgrimages, gathered disciples around me, and performed services. And all that without ever changing my pants. Finally, a gypsy told me that it had only been a nightmare. Oh, Ben, you can hardly imagine how embarrassed I was. 5 years in a monastery, simply because I had chili casserole before bedtime.
Okay, you know what? I'll just look it up myself.
You know what? I'll just look it up myself.
Yes, couldn't hurt. I might still seem quite bright in the head.
Oh, yeah?
But sometimes the details get a little mixed up.
Oh, okay. See you later.
See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
Ben. So look, he got small again.
Have you given Spot something to drink yet?
Yes, Ben, I have.
Well, then you can start practicing your human cannonball act.
They respond differently to him whether he's blown up or normal sized.
No, you shouldn't let Spot eat so much grass. He already has a rather unhealthy complexion.
Like you, Grandpa?
He'll start to gather moss.
Yeah, like you, Grandpa.
How big is this thing? Okay. Can we go all the way back? Just trying to test the limits of our environment here. No, I can't get past the clothesline. Looks like we can only go this way. What about the coffin?
Where are you going?
I want to look around the forest.
Don't get lost.
Don't worry.
What?
What the?
I could have told you that. You and your sense of orientation.
So what the hell are we supposed to do? We can't leave this scene? We can only go in and out of the trailer?
Hi, Ben.
Oh, what do you want this time?
Why am I always getting lost?
Why am I always getting lost?
Because you're good for nothing. That's why.
How sweet.
Orientation is just another thing on the long list of your inabilities. Without a map and a compass, you wouldn't even find your own feet. And what exactly are you doing?
Looking for a map
I'm
and a compass.
I'm looking for my feet so I can kick you for what you just said.
Huh. Where can I get a map?
Where can I get a map?
I've got one in the trailer. It won't be easy for you to find, though.
Why?
You know how senile Grandpa is. I hid the map because he keeps mistaking it for one of his recipes.
Oh, yeah. I remember. If I ever have to eat Northeast again, I'll be sick for sure.
Where can I get a compass?
Where can I get a compass?
I think Grandpa has one. Why don't you go and ask him?
Great. I might as well ask Bruno. Grandpa is so senile, he forgets what you asked if he tries to string two sentences together.
I might be a bit senile, but I've still got 2 ears with which I can still see very clearly.
Oh my, that won't be easy. See you.
Yep. See you. And don't forget, you're a clown.
Don't forget, you're a clown. Alright, I got it open, okay. Hold on. I couldn't open this at the end of last episode.
Hey, isn't that Ben's casket?
Oh, that was just weird.
Though thinking out of the box may be a good idea, and talking into a box seems rather stupid.
Seems rather stupid. Here.
I better not show that to him. He hates it when I go through his things.
Okay, here.
Grandpa is not a private person. On the contrary, he's an open book. But one whose letters have begun to fade, I must admit.
Bruno, I want this.
Don't mess with Bruno, unlike you. He's already done his work for today.
Okay, well, we gotta talk to Grandpa anyway.
Hello, Grandpa.
Ah, hello, Ben. Is your hat still too tight?
What's the thing with that tiny casket? He's not saying anything interesting about it. It's just tiny little casket. What's it for? I want to take a look around the autumn forest, but I keep getting lost.
I want to take a look around the autumn forest, but I keep getting lost.
If you want to go for a walk, have you given Spot something to drink yet?
Yes, Grandpa. All done and finished.
Well, you've earned a little walk then. Ah, but be careful. The autumn forest is big and dense. Yeah, very, very much like my beard. You can very easily get lost in it. Again, very much like my beard.
I already noticed that.
You'd better take my comb. I mean compass with you. Now where did I put it? I know, it's in the trailer. Under the bed.
Great. Thanks, Grandpa. Under the bed, right?
Yes, under the bed. I like to take a pinch late at night.
Take a pinch? Off the compass?
Yes, I know, it's unhealthy. But at my age, well...
Are you sure you're talking about the compass? Don't you mean compote?
Compote? What are you insinuating? Did you nose around my notes? Besides, if I planned anything like that, it would be none of your business.
Oh,
you
brother.
You must consider all the consequences of such a compote, you know.
A compote with broad ramifications?
Yes, so you'd better keep your nose out of it.
Oh, Grandpa, you're talking about a complot. You're planning a complot.
A complot? I have no idea what you're talking about. You don't need to plan a complot. I just made one not 10 minutes ago, right behind the trailer.
That's compost.
Impossible. I carry the compost with me all the time.
Oh my god.
It's in my pocket. I'm pretty sure it is. Just a second.
Give me the compass. Thank you.
Grandpa, that's not compost. That's the compass.
Really? Then where's the compost? Would you mind checking under my bed?
Sure. Just remind me again later, okay? Now, I'm taking a walk in the autumn forest.
Might be back for lunch, you hear?
No, thanks. I really don't care for petroleum soup.
What's that?
Oh, nothing really. Thanks, Grandpa.
Oh my god, see you later.
See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
Can I... Yeah, that's right. Can I go in here?
The door is rotten and loose-fitting. It's pretty chilly during the night. It's a miracle that Grandpa hasn't died of pneumonia. Grandpa, can I go into your trailer?
Of course, my boy. You want to take a little petroleum soup, don't you? Who would take offense at that?
Maybe my insides?
Okay, so we can go in here. Entree. Okay, the autumn forest. We'll have to wait a little bit because there's, wow, a lot of stuff in here.
The door is rotten and loose-fitting. It's pretty chilly during the night. It's a miracle that Grandpa hasn't died of pneumonia.
Is that a snake? And that's obviously a frog. Dentures, okay.
Hey, Grandpa! Did you know your exit is leaking?
Well, don't you shout a bit louder so everybody will know. I already take medication for that.
Text was cut off. A cork.
We have much in common. This bottle is corked and I'm screwed up. I can't open bottles with my teeth anymore. Since Ben pulled that trick with the painted stone.
The trick with the painted stone. What is that? Tunk. So we've got our cork. Okay. Dentures. Oh, yay.
That's Grandpa's third pair already. The last two were eaten by woodworm, and it's only a matter of time with these. I'm not putting those in my mouth, and I have my size nor my taste.
Oh, you got them, though. A handkerchief underneath.
Yuck.
Yeah, yuck. You got the friggin'... what do you call it? The dentures in your pocket.
I'm sorry, but I won't put that into my mouth. Not when there's the slightest possibility that Grandpa blew his nose on it.
Let's look at this frog.
Grandpa has always had a soft spot for animals.
Not soft enough, this poor thing.
Raw?
Oh, we're eating it, okay.
I'd rather leave him in there. It wouldn't be much fun to suck it through with a bottleneck for either of us.
A cookbook.
Well, who would have thought? Those really are regular recipes. There goes my theory that Grandpa is preparing our meals from the fishing bait manual. Grandpa's cooking is inspired more by enthusiasm than by real talent. Maybe we should spare him the trouble and just eat the cookbook. It would save time and effort.
You're talking like a robot now.
Cooking is one of Grandpa's tasks, not mine. Not that I didn't offer to cook, but Ben objected. It's a sign of how low his esteem for me is. I mean, petroleum soup? Seriously. Cooking is one of Grandpa's. Not that I did not. It's a shot. I mean.
Okay, we can't take that. Cauldron.
Grandpa's latest creation, petroleum soup. Inflammatory on the stomach, highly flammable in general, and a hazard to all low flying birds in the vicinity.
Is that. That's a creature. That's a mouth that keeps blowing that. It's messed up looking.
Maybe I should make Spot taste it first. There they are, Spot. I'm just joking. Ouch! Hot.
A hairnet.
Grandpa's hairnet. He always uses it when he doesn't want his hair to get wet. When taking a bath, when he's cooking, and while he's asleep.
He should wash his hair.
Yeah, yummy. Can there be anything better than the revitalizing feeling of lice crawling between your teeth?
This is a nasty trailer. I don't like this trailer. Notes.
More recipes. Grandpa's cooking is inspired more by enthusiasm than by real talent. Maybe we should spare him. It would save.
Yeah, I see that.
Well, who would have thought? Those really are regular recipes. There goes my theory that.
About these recipes, you guys gonna say the same thing?
Well, who would have thought? There goes my. Hey, Grandpa! Who gave you all these recipes?
That's a secret, my boy. But one thing I can tell you. They're very valuable, so don't get them mixed up. I had to promise the swamp troll.
Swamp troll?
Cooking is one of Grandpa's tasks, not that I didn't. It's a shine. I mean.
Alright, so we've got a jar of eyes and a bottle.
Beaver eyes. Grandpa uses them as cooking ingredients. He calls the dish eye candy.
Ugh.
Grandpa says, once you've gotten used to them, they're really tasty. What he doesn't say is how long it takes to get used to them. Unreachable, like so many things. The blood of earthworms. The bottle is almost empty again. I'd rather not. The blood of the earthworms has to last throughout the winter. Last time, we had to replenish our supply. There was snow on the ground. It was hell.
unreachable, like so many things.
But we have a spot.
How about it, Spot? Care for some earthworm blood? I thought so. Not even Spot likes Grandpa's eye candy, and he'll eat almost anything.
Okay, down for some boiled Spot.
Spot is not going into the soup, no matter how much Grandpa keeps bugging me.
He keeps bugging you to put it in there?
There are some juicy recipes with worms in here, too. I'd better not let Spot see those. No, Spot, there's nothing to see here. Caterpillars are way better pets. Toads can hardly hold anything.
Alright.
I hope to teach, but he just can't.
Oh, I gotta do that and then do that. Okay. So here's this compass we got. We gotta get the map. It's under the bed, but I don't know which trailer. He didn't specify.
The compass needle points north. It's all quiet, dull, and monotonous there. Must be great.
Oops.
The compass needle where people must be great.
What do you say, where people know how to be quiet or something?
The compass needle points north, where people still know how to keep quiet. The compass needle
where women.
What?
The compass needle points north, where women wear long, waving hair, and the men have tremendous beards. The compass needle points north, where the temperature is so low, you can't even come down with a cold.
Is it one for every item?
The compass needle points north, where people are armed to the teeth. The compass needle points north, where relatives have no secrets from each other. I once tried to build a compass out of a cork stopper. Luckily, Grandpa had a real compass. My adventure would have lasted longer than necessary otherwise. The compass needle points north, where it's so lonely that people have nothing to do. The compass needle points north, where people bury themselves in the snow when they've had enough. The compass needle points north. That might be the direction in which an enraged posse of bears is planning revenge. Memo to self, avoid the north long range. And just to be sure, all other directions as well.
Well, that's interesting. Now what if we take something like this?
Why not? Of course, I could try thinking out of the box for once. Grandpa's dentures really need to be cleaned, but he'd better do it himself. Ooh, let's hope that's only spinach.
Yeah.
I just made a decision. Never grow as old as Grandpa. There are a million ways to use a cork. This one resembles my own life best, being completely useless. The compass, where the temperature is. I'd better not bury that. Maybe I'll need it later. It's not on my schedule to blow Grandpa's nose. Actually, his cold got better. Haven't I already broken enough? The compass, where a relative.
Now what could possibly actually interact with something?
I'd better not bury that. I'm going.
Alright, well. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. So, oh, wait a second. Wait, is it under this bed? How do I look under the bed? I think it's in my trailer. Under the bed? How do I look under the bed? Wait, no, that's what Grandpa said as far as the compass. Be under the rug?
The rug may look fluffy, but I'm not touching it. I don't want to smell like a dead bear when I go into the woods.
Is the map in there? Oh wait, there's a key!
Ben must have hidden it here. He only does that to annoy me. He knows very well I just hate pointed teeth. I could lose a hand if I reach into there. Stay where you are! I'm coming to save you! On second thought, maybe I'll just get some help. Yeah. Oh, shoot. I'm such a terrible coward.
Okay, just get it.
Ah! Oh boy, that was close. Ben will pay for this. I could have croaked.
Huh. Alright, the key.
I'm sure Ben only hit the key to tease me. Alright, I'll say no more.
Oh, I bet you the key opens the casket and the map's in there.
I wonder if that's the key to Ben's casket.
Try it.
It matches. The casket is open.
Yay. And inside?
Now it's empty.
Ah, because there's the map.
Though thinking out of the box and talking in.
Yeah, I'm done with that.
Now I shouldn't get lost anymore. No, that's not a menu. Said the clown, but no one laughed.
Haha, I laughed. Okay. Can I put that in?
Why not? Of course, I...
Alright, never mind. Now we can enter the forest. Should I tell him we found the stuff?
Hi, Ben.
Oh, what do you want this time?
Nope.
See you.
Yep. See you. And don't forget, you're a...
Shit. Into the forest we go.
Oh dear, he's getting more and more difficult each day.
He's still young. He hasn't found his responsibilities in the world yet.
He should carry out his responsibilities to the circus first, before looking for new ones.
I heard that.
Oh, by the way, I hate you, both of you. I just wanted to get that off my chest. Never mind me.
Oops.
Ben is in a bad mood today.
Oh, shut up, Grandpa. Just be quiet, will you?
Alright. The shore. The circus. That's where we are now. We can only go... here. I can't go into the forest? No. Oh.
Yikes! There's somebody there.
That's right.
A stranger. I wonder what he's doing here.
We have time to talk to him? Coming up on a half hour.
The island seems to be inhabited, but it's too far away to swim there. I don't think anyone will hear me if I call out.
He will. Messenger?
I don't think anyone will see me if I wave.
Hmm.
The water looks downright cloudy. No, wait. That's just a reflection of my face.
Again?
No, thanks. I have a craving for other things, like a useful occupation, for example, or respect.
Hey.
I'll wash my hands later. I've got the feeling I'll get my hands dirty a couple more times today.
Oh, a branch. Hooray for
branch. Exciting.
Oh yeah, hooray, hooray.
It's too big for a toothpick.
Okay. Stay tuned for next episode when we talk to the messenger. See you next time. Thanks for watching. As always, appreciate it. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.